If you see 9th canto, 3rd chapter, 20th verse, Srila Prabhupada has spoken about the chastity of a woman, Sukanya. She was so dedicated in the service of her husband Chayan Muni, who was very old and also very irritating nature. He had the irritating nature. But still, Sukanya served him very, very sincerely. That is why Ashwini Kumars were very happy. And they blessed Chayan Muni with wonderful, handsome body. When Sukanya's father sees that this daughter is sitting with some handsome person, father scolds her. But again, Sukanya says, no, he is the same person to whom you got me married. In that purpose, Srila Prabhupada writes very nicely about the chastity of a woman. So woman has many different wonderful roles. Why take the role of a Diksha Guru, which is not recommended? Because if a woman wants to take the role of a Diksha Guru, then we should also understand what is the role of a Diksha Guru. Diksha Guru has the capacity to take the sins of others. Now for that, he cannot be a papayoni. A woman is considered to be a papayoni according to Krishna. And we cannot deny Krishna's statements. Now, a person who is in papayoni, how can that person take the sins of others? Even Kunti Maharani in her prayer says, katham pashyena hi striha. How am I going to understand the glories of Krishna? So in this way she expresses very humbly. Katham pashyena hi striha. Though Kunti Maharani got the benediction that she can invoke any demigod and ask any benedictions, Srila Prabhupada mentions in one of the lectures, but still Kunti Maharani always expressed her humility. She never said, oh, I am a wonderful woman, I can invoke any demigod. She never said that. So, if you read the Shastras, there was no fight for the woman's rights. So, all these things are actually not allowing a woman to really understand what wonderful nature Krishna has given by which we can invoke Krishna's mercy.